Hello, my name is Amit Kochhar, and I'm director of the Facial Nerve Disorders Program at Pacific Neuroscience Institute in Santa Monica, California. What is Gracilis free tissue transfer for facial reanimation? For patients with chronic facial paralysis that's lasted greater than 12 to 18 months, they may no longer be eligible for nerve transfer procedures to help reanimate their face. In these cases, we often perform Gracilis free tissue transfer. This is a state-of-the-art procedure which requires microvascular reconstruction, in which muscle, nerve, artery, and vein are transplanted from your inner thigh to your face and tunneled under the cheek. They're inset to the corner of the mouth so that you can help recreate your smile. The nerve is then anastomosed or connected to different branches in the face. It can either be from a cross face graft, which comes from the other side of the face, connecting to functioning facial nerve branches, which is tunneled under the lip, or it can be connected to the masseter nerve, which is in the cheek when you bite down, which activates the masseter muscle. Sometimes we use both, or sometimes we use one or the other. It really depends on your patient's specific needs. Approximately 3 to 6 months after the surgery is performed, patients will notice that they're able to start moving the affected side by either biting down or by smiling on their contralateral side. The surgery does require a hospitalization because it is microvascular surgery. Patients require 1 to 2 days in the ICU for close observation to make sure there's no issues with the artery bringing blood flow in or the vein removing the blood flow. If there is, we may have to return to the operating room. However, that happens only in extremely rare cases. Typically, patients will be transferred from the ICU to a step-down unit for another 3 to 4 days, and usually will leave the hospital upon postoperative day 5 or 6. After their hospitalization, they will return to the office to have any stitches or sutures removed, and then at about 1 week, and then in about 1 month, we'll see you back for follow-up at 2 months, 3 months, and 6 months. Again, it's typically between 3 to 4 months where patients will start to develop movement on that side, and it's typically done by biting down. Because we're using chewing muscles to activate the new smile muscle of the gracilis, we do ask patients to stay on a soft diet for about 4 to 6 weeks, just so that during the healing process. They can eat on the other side, and then usually after about 4 to 6 weeks, they can start to advance to a regular diet again. The thigh wound usually heals pretty well. Patients have very minimal morbidity, which means that they don't have any side effects from it. If you have any redness or swelling at that site, it might be a sign that there could be an infection and we should see you in office to discuss. The incision on the face is a typical facelift incision, and so it's well hidden. Sometimes, depending on the type of patient, we may have to make an incision just a little bit into the neck, but again, it's very well healed. If there's any scarring or wound healing issues from that incision, we can potentially laser them or inject them with steroid if we need to. Again, that's very rare. If you have any other questions about Gracilis free tissue transfer for facial reanimation, please contact one of our MAs directly or myself via email, and we'll get back to you with any questions or concerns that you may have. Thank you very much.